Welcome back, gang. So now that our main nav is taken care of, we can go ahead and start this one up here. We can go ahead and start working on our sidebar. Now, if you're not sure or you want to see how it's going to look, you can go ahead and take a look at the very first introduction episode, and that one shows the whole layout of what we're building here. But as it stands right now, what I want to do is I want to go to resources. Resources JS layouts, and I want to open up our app layout.view file. Now here we already added a spot for it. I'm just going to go ahead and move this up just to be a little bit more consistent. And in here I'm going to create a sidebar component. Sidebar. Okay, so let's go ahead and add that component here. So we'll go to our main JS file. We'll add a new folder. We're going to call it components. And this will be all the components that we pull out to make them reusable so we can use them in other places. So we'll go to new file and we create a new component called sidebar.view. Enter. Okay, so what I want to do here is just go ahead and start fleshing it out. For the template, for now, we're just going to add a sidebar just so that we can confirm that it works. And then our export default is going to go here. And then go back to app layout. Now we need to import this component. So we'll go down to import sidebar from at slash components slash sidebar, and then down here in the list of components we'll add sidebar. Okay, so it should recognize it now. Let's go and take a look. We'll come back to our page, refresh. Okay, great. So now you see sidebar over here, and that's exactly what we want. So let's go over to the component and start designing it. Okay, in here I want to add an aside class, since it is an aside. There's some talk about using the HTML elements correctly. I think it's a personal preference, and if you want to follow that, go ahead. I think it might look better if you do. I've been trying to be more vigilant about trying to get it done properly, or the accepted way of doing it. But you can also use divs however you want to work it. As long as it works, then you know that's all you really need, is as long as it works. But if you're unfamiliar with them, I would definitely go Google that and check that out and see if it's something you might want to, you know, if you're learning how to make things more just sort of modal based, then yeah, definitely. Okay, so the style we want to add here, it's flex call. We're going to make the background of white. We're going to have shadow. It'll be a padding Y of 6. Width full. And on small screens, we're going to have a width of 1/3. And on large screens, we're going to have a width of 1/4. Okay. We want to add a link in, since we know that our sidebar is going to have a list of links. So the first one is going to be inertia link. And then we can open a bracket. Hopefully that works now. href equals, and then enter. Okay, cool. So we'll put a hashtag in there for now. We'll go ahead and style this a little bit. So we'll have flex items end padding left of 6, padding y of 2, text gray of 800. On the hover, we want the background to be gray, 500. And then also on the hover, we want the text to be white. Okay, so let's go ahead and open up this Inertia class. So now we can put an image class so that we can see our profile image. We'll put a colon here. And then it'll be $ page props user profile photo URL. Okay, and let's just copy and paste this and we'll change it. Copy. Paste. And instead of profile photo URL, we'll change it to username. And we'll add a colon here. Okay, so now right after the image, we'll go ahead and put a span class. ML2. Hopefully this works. Okay, cool. And then we want some curly brackets, curly braces, whichever you want to call them, it's fine. Just as long as you know what it is. Page props username. Okay, let's just refresh and make sure that's fine. Okay, don't worry about this stuff over here. This is going to be taken care of in the next episode when we start dealing with the rest of the page layout. Okay, well, that works. I need to put some image classes on the, or some classes on the image. So we'll go ahead and put that, we'll put it at the end of this image class equals, we'll do a height of 8, a width of 8, rounded, full, and this will give it a nice round circle around it. Cover. Okay, so let's try this again. Refresh. And hopefully it'll be at the correct size. And it is. Okay, so now when we hover it, got that nice little effect. Okay, well, I think I'm going to leave it here and push it up to GitHub. If you have any questions, please go ahead and feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll try to get to it as quickly as possible. I'll go ahead and push this up to GitHub. Thanks again for watching and see you guys next episode.